Welcome to St Dominic's.
Hello, this is St Dominic's. Firstly, we apologise for the makeshift video, but in this current situation, because we can't welcome you into the school physically, we thought we'd try virtually. So do bear with me as I take you around the school and try and give you a taste and flavour of who we are. The St Dominic's is a Catholic independent school, ranged from age 3 all the way to 16. We pride ourselves on kind spirit and the ethos of the Catholic faith, although we welcome children of all abilities, of all faiths, and we want children with lots of strengths and maybe weaknesses, because we're a family. And we believe a family needs to have all those different entities so we can learn from each other. We pride ourselves on small class sizes, 18 in our primary school and a maximum of 20 in our senior school. And this ensures that your child gets the very best attention. And we know every child. By knowing every child, we can not only tailor their educational requirements to ensure that we guide and gently push and mould to make them be the best they can be, but we also the well-roundedness of a child to make sure that they are confident, a happy individual when they leave this school. We're very blessed this year in January to have the grand reveal of our three-storey senior teaching block. This has been designed specifically with our current and future pupils in mind. I was extremely blessed to be able to individually plan and design all the classrooms and bespoke science labs, art studio, even a classroom on the roof that makes fantastic opportunities of our canal view side. We've been able to think of what our children need and the future curriculum offering we would like to deliver to this school. So we've now got all of the resources ready. So I'm really looking forward to showing you around that building. Shall we go? We can fit up to 16 children in here. Obviously at the moment we've got individual desks because we're adhering to social distancing where possible. But it's a fantastic space for our youngest of St Dominic's family to learn not only through lessons but also through play. And then take you through to our reception. So very closely connected, these two classrooms. And our reception classroom here for our pupils preparing to start school. Excuse the social distancing, normally the rooms are much fuller with lots more activities and lots more kinetic items for the children, but we've had to strip that back at this COVID time. But I hope you get a feel for the space, and then takes you straight out to the outside area where the children have free flow and enjoy their break times and free time. Upstairs here on the first floor we have our classrooms for years 1 and 2. Lovely sized classrooms, lots of space, lots of different areas for the different types of learning that they carry out. Now in the Croft building, which houses our prep school for years 3, 4 and 5. This is a year 4 classroom, but they're all very similar. Every room's got a Promethean interactive board and lots of space, as you can see, for our children to enjoy their learning. And then every door connects straight to our new building. Welcome welcome to our prep ICT room, currently being taken over by our key worker children, and we're enabling to keep safe during this time. But normally it would be open to our early years children all the way to P6. They come in here and have discrete ICT lessons, as well as being able to use the computers for research or to study any other topic. Next door to the Prep ICT is our design technology room. Lots of things happen here, lots of things are made and designed, and this is available from year 5 to year 9. What room I'm in now. This is one of our science labs, but this is our primary science lab. We believe that trying to keep children engaged in those core subjects, so from P3 upwards, our children are able to come into this science lab and they're taught by a discrete science teacher. Fantastic room, again, floor to ceiling windows, lots of light, teaching wall, everything they need to explore the wonders of science. At our new building that we opened in January of this year. So this houses all of our senior classrooms, science labs and art room, but also a lot of rooms for our prep children as well. So come on in. So we have 5 general teaching classrooms on each floor, and views of the playground on one side and glass aspect, and then views of the canal on the other side. So here's an example of one of our general teaching classrooms. This is one of my English rooms. Every classroom has a teaching wall. This is used for storage of books and so on, but with a whiteboard across the whole width, and then that hides our interactive screen for each classroom. Moving on into the west wing, we've got lockers, secure lockers for all the children on both floors of the building, still viewing out onto our playground, and then on this floor we've got peripatetic rooms to practice rooms for music and our music and drama studio. One of my favourite rooms, this is the music and drama studio. We've got electronic doors across the middle that will divide the room into two, giving us our free space for drama and dance, and then the other space for music, but allowing us to open it up as well for intimate performances and assemblies. We've also got bifold doors that open out onto our mugger. This is P6 social distancing classroom at the moment, but I hope you can imagine what a wonderful space it is. We have 3 stairwells in each corner of the new building. We also have lift access for anybody who needs it. Okay, we're on the first floor now, in one of our general teaching classrooms. This is our French classroom. We have French, Spanish, RE, Geography and History on this floor. The higher we get, the better the view. So we've got a wonderful aspect again of the canal view. Welcome to our art studio. Lots of light, airy space on our first floor of the building now. We offer a GCSE in art and also design textiles. We have a kiln in the room next door, so we can do ceramics as well. So we've got everything we need to explore the wonderful talent of St Dominic's pupils.
first floor not only covers the general teaching classrooms, again, and specific art and drama studio, but scattered around the building are our SEN and private study rooms, so that children can go in small groups or one-to-one and get additional tuition. And then moving on upstairs now to our final floor. New building now, so this is our biology lab. We have three discrete science labs as well as our prep science lab. We have a biology, chemistry and physics lab, and our chem store is on this floor as well. Aren't we lucky to have this wonderful outside space, this extra outside classroom for our pupils? Lots to do, obviously. It's a bit desolate at the moment because our pupils aren't in, but we use it for our eco club to grow different fruits and vegetables. We'll be hosting bees in our beehive, but the uses are endless, the amount of things we can use it for. We're very excited. Here we are in the dining hall. We have external caterers who serve food from 8 to 8:30, which is our breakfast provision. We then have break time and then lunchtime, obviously, for all the children here. Lunch is available in different guises, hot meals, panini of the day, all our menus are on the website. Although they're external caterers, the staff that serve our children have been with the school now over 8 to 9 years, so they know every child. And they gently encourage them to eat healthily and to eat a good meal. Welcome to our sports hall! A fantastic resource we've got here, our sports hall, which services the PE needs of children as young as early years all the way to our year 11 pupils for their discrete PE lessons, but also for our clubs at lunchtime and after school, climbing wall for example. So all of our extracurricular activities, as well as the competitive sports and inviting other schools to come and compete here as well. Our multi-use school hall, and it's definitely multi-use at the moment because, as you can see, these are our hand washing stations when the children and staff arrive and leave at the beginning and end of the day. But we use this hall for everything. When we do have a full complement of pupils, we have primary small children having music and movement in here, we have practice peripatetic lessons, we'll have assemblies, we also host lots of performances throughout the year, especially our whole school production. We enjoyed the Whiz this year, it's fantastic. Welcome to our schoolhouse. This is a building that we had refurbished recently. Mainly it's a school office for the senior pupils. They can come on in, speak to staff in the school office and ask for new locker key or any sort of resources or messages they need. But in the building, it houses our administration staff, finance and marketing, and also my office and our pupil library. So in the schoolhouse, we've got a nice library for different ages within the school. So this is our senior library. They can come in here and quietly do some study or read a book. And then downstairs, we've got a more of a snuggle area for our younger children. Thank you. Well, you made it to the end of the tour, so thank you for sticking with me. I hope it's helped to give you a flavour of St Dominic's and what we're all about. So all that leaves me to say is goodbye, and I look forward to be able to be welcoming many visitors and pupils back very shortly.